A major tool that we're working to develop is predicting the postmortem interval from the microbes that are present on the body or on the soil near the body when it's discovered, and using them to tell how long that person's been dead. We study the microbial ecology of vertebrate decomposition. From an application perspective, we're really interested in understanding whether there's a predictable succession of microbes, whether there's the same sort of waves of microbes at the same time during decomposition, because then that allows us to build tools to help predict how long that person's been dead.
This microbiome dataset represents one of, if not the largest on human decomposition to date. We're talking about thousands of samples. We collected daily soil and skin swab samples from 36 human cadavers over the first few weeks of the decomposition process. From our samples, we were able to generate a mass amount of DNA sequencing data for understanding how these microbial communities respond to decomposition products, the products that are present in the system for the microbes to use and exchange with each other, and how these microbes are likely working together in a cooperative manner to perform the actual decomposition process itself.
These results are important because forensic science is an applied science, and applied science is only as good as the basic research that it's grounded in. Forensic science is strongly grounded in biology, so the greater the understanding of the biology of decomposition, the better our models are and the more precise our forensic tools can be.
Recent research has found that microbial communities actually change in a manner that's pretty predictive of the PMI, meaning that the presence or absence of certain microbial species can potentially serve as an indicator for how long a body has been decomposing. In this study, we were able to leverage that extremely large-scale dataset that we collected to generate these really accurate predictive models across of our climates, along with generating a subset of microbes that were deemed the most informative for an accurate prediction of that PMI.
There are two really exciting next steps that we're going to pursue together as a team. The first is to look at decomposition indoors. In this study, like our past studies, we were looking at decomposition outdoors, but a lot of bodies are found indoors, and so we need to study that. The second is to work with decomposition facilities all around North America to get a much better picture of the different conditions that people can decompose under, and to understand the breadth and generality of these decomposer networks, which will also allow us to build up a better database that allows predictions that are specific to individual sites.